Hello, it's a sunny Sunday. Look, I got another fish, but this one is a dorade, which is gilled head in English, and this one is gutted and scaled. I've just got a little lemon juice sitting on it. These are called coco plop, and my spouse chopped them up, and I've got water boiling, never salted, because this is a stainless steel pot. And I'm going to blanch them and cool them and put them in little containers and freeze them. I think we're going to have some cucumber and some zucchini today, maybe a potato, I don't know. I've got to get to the store. We've got a vote today. Look at this huge bread. This is like a monster bread, right? I don't eat bread. I'm gluten intolerant, but whoa. This looks amazing. France is great for bread. this is like, I just did the nerdiest clip about doing laundry in a French washing machine. We might go to Paris later today, but I'm not sure if I'm going to go with him. My legs are still very gouty. Oh, thanks to EconCat88 for recommending a fresh pineapple. I took out the juicer and I juiced half of it yesterday. It was delicious. I don't think it helped, but I don't think it hurt either. And the other half I sliced up and chilled and gave to my husband for his dessert yesterday, and he enjoyed it. Also, the produce guy was confused and sold it to us for 50 euro cents, which was kind of cool. Who knows where those things come from off season, but you know. They don't grow here in France anyway, so they're not politically correct. I would like to talk about, there have been a lot of things I've been wanting to talk about. I knew this lady a few years ago. Her name is Gilberte, which is a typical French name for a woman. It's Gilberte in English. Men over here have the names of flowers and seasons and months. But women frequently have masculine names, which can be very confusing. And sometimes you'll find men named Mary or Marie or whatever. It's a different culture. Oh, the clock is the wrong time. I have to change that. And she was raised in an orphanage here in France. And she wasn't abused or anything, but she didn't enjoy it. And her mother had been a prostitute, a Parisian prostitute, and the father was her pimp. And the father died in prison some years later. She was given up for adoption immediately. And the mother would be in her 80s if she's alive today, and never made any attempt to find out where her daughter was. And Gilberte felt very rejected by all this. And so Gilberte, who works as a concierge, you know, she's like the janitor lady for an apartment building, had this very firm idea in life that what she really wanted was, you know, to get married and have children and have a normal family, such as what she had never had. And she ended up having 4 kids. And they're all adults now, and they're all fine. And she has a wonderful husband who loves her, and last I saw them, he was retired, and they got along great. And she really had a marvelous life, except she had some problems at a job she had in Persan, north of here. Some of the neighbors were harassing her. So she got depressed and had to be medicated for a while and stuff, and then she got transferred to another building in another part of France, and they're okay now, but she's still getting some treatment for mental issues. And one of the things that really bothers her to this day, is that of her 3 children, one of them, a boy, who's in his 30s now, and is married and has at least 1 child, has never been close to her. And this bothers her. She kept saying to me, but it shouldn't be that way. I'm his mother. I carried him in my belly. I was good to him. And I said to her, you know, Gilberte, was he a problem child? And she said, no, he was good. He's a good boy. He's a good man. And I said, so what is the problem? You know, once somebody gets to be like age 18 or 20 or something, it's time to cut the umbilical cord. You know, he has his own life now. If he's not extremely attached to his mom, this really shouldn't be a problem. And your other three children are very close to you and you talk to them all the time. And she was just so disturbed about this. She just couldn't accept it. And I said to her, Gilberte, you're the one who's not being reasonable because you have this idea of how things in life should be. You know, there should be a husband and wife and children, and there shouldn't be orphans, and you shouldn't get problems at your job, and your children should love you all the time and behave a certain way. And that one son of yours, he's not nasty to you, is he? And she said, oh, no, but I only talk to his wife, and he really doesn't want to have much to do with me. And I must say, my husband is quite the same with his parents, and he's only talking to his mother a lot now because the father is dying, and it's necessary, you know, for him to advise her and help her out, but he doesn't like it. He doesn't feel very good about it. You know, he just never loved his parents. Really. He just didn't. And that doesn't make him necessarily a bad person, and it doesn't necessarily make his parents bad people. You know, that's just how it is. You know, I hope this makes sense to you. I've got an old bananilla tin. I keep almonds in here. See, these funny black images, black African, this is Le Camerounais, used to be very, very typical in France when I moved here, and now they're not PC anymore. So I've got this as kind of a souvenir. This is a breakfast drink, le petit déjeuner familial. All right, see you later, bye.